Hi, I'm Heather. I'm one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. In this video, we're going to take a look at when a sensor state changes. So come on over and let's get started. All right, so let's look at how the sensors, when it does change a state. There's two types of sensor state changes you can have. The first type is when a sensor does not respond when it's pulling. The first time it doesn't respond, it goes into warning, and second time to down by default. And you can change those settings here under settings. And if I go to scanning interval, you could change the query here. I have another video that I do dive deeply into the various different sensor states that we have, so you can also take a look at that. That's the first time when a sensor state will change, though, is if it just doesn't respond. The second way is based upon limits or lookup values. So any sensor that is measurable, you can set limits. So a good example is disk free. And limits are actually set on the sensor channel. So if you take a look here at my gouge, you see I have an area for green, an area for yellow for warning, and an area for down. So if you go into the gearbox here under a gouge, or on the side, I can also edit channel settings on the right side here on the gear. And when that comes up, you're going to see enable alerting based upon limits. Now, if you go into a sensor that has no limit set, you'll see that the disable limits is here. You just click on enable alerting based upon limits. You can have upper limits or lower limits on a sensor. An upper limit you might set if you're looking at CPU utilization, bandwidth monitoring, but since we're looking at disk free here, I want to define lower limits because I want to be notified when I hit a low number. So by default, you see it's 25% for warning and 10% for error. So just so you can see how the gouge changes, I'm going to put 50 for warning, 25 for error. I'm going to say okay. And now you're going to see here that this sensor is technically in this warning area because I changed my limits. So the sensor state would go to warning. So this gives you a lot of control around how your sensor states change if you do it that way. The other example for if something isn't measurable based upon data quantity, then you're going to use lookup values. So a good example for that is I'm going to take a look at my Dell System Health sensor here. And because this is just returning values based upon the hardware, if the hardware is deemed to be in warning or if it's in it's in a down state. So I'm going to go into my sensor channel for this particular sensor, and you're going to see here it's enable alerting based upon lookup values, and it's just taking a lookup file that comes from the hardware, and this is the standard lookup file for Dell status. Different pieces of hardware have different lookup files, and then they are stored on your PRTG server. You can go and edit those files as well. I don't encourage you to do that a whole lot because you really can change the validity of the data that comes back. But there may be times that, you know, for you, even though the hardware manufacturer deems that something's down, for you it's up, and then you can edit it that way. So it reads a lookup file, and based upon that, reading the data from the sensor, for that particular piece of hardware, it will return it, and then it will change the sensor state that way. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com. And always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.